Chair of this session, Sri Janaya Ji, His Excellency Dr. Andrew Fleming, Deputy High Commissioner of UK, His Excellency Sri Mehdi Farooqi Ji, Consul General from Iran, delegates, friends, the topic for today's deliberation, as I'll put it, robust energy ecosystem. As has been mentioned a few times, renewable energy is the thing, and it will acquire more and more importance in the days to come. 4 years back, at the national level, when the target was set by our Honorable Prime Minister for the country, 175 GW, many thought, including me, I am being honest, at that point of time I was in the energy sector, that it's a very ambitious target. We may not be able to achieve it. The practical view taken informally was, let's try for it, even if we are not able to achieve it, even if we are falling short of it slightly, it will be much, much worth the effort. Today, whatever my energy colleagues all over the country, other stakeholders have achieved is commendable. As Mr. Janaya put, with 156 GW by 2021 ending, now 1 year to go, I am confident we'll be reaching 175 GW by end of next year, which means approximately 45% of our energy will be through renewable sector. I have mentioned in few of my speeches during the last 2-3 months. Till now we have been focusing on individual renewable energy sectors, solar, wind, rooftop, waste to energy, biomass, but we have to focus on what I call firm renewable energy. Firm renewable energy means, or what I mean by that is, 24/7 we should be able to deliver the energy needs of the consumers through green modalities. Gradually, global level, the sentiment is growing more and more against fossil fuels. When we are able to put an end to the present fossil fuel consumption, that is our objective now. See, growing of renewable energy is one, but the ending of the fossil fuel journey, that is more important. Whether we call it zero emission, whether we call it to say net zero, finally, it boils down to 1.5 degree centigrade climate change prevention, which is crucial for our well-being and our healthy survival, I'll put it. In this context, one of the initiatives which has been taken this year by the national government is to promote hydrogen fuel energy sector. Our Honorable Prime Minister mentioned it on the Independence Day speech. The details are being rolled out. The private sector is taking initiatives. It may be duplication of my statistics, but two big industrial houses in this country have committed through public statements or releases $20 billion in the next one decade for renewable energy, and that includes substantively for hydrogen fuel economy. And in hydrogen fuel economy also for what is called green hydrogen. Last decade, we have seen tremendous progress in solar energy, substantive in wind energy. These two sectors will continue to grow much, much more in the coming decade. But I am confident that in the coming decade, hydrogen fuel research will also lead to a point where it will become financially sustainable, where at least to start with, the big energy guzzlers, the industries, they will start moving towards hydrogen. Some of them have already started that hydrogen, but more important, what I call green hydrogen. Green hydrogen sector, as on now, is capital intensive. It requires, or only the big players will come in first, and later others will join. So there, that is one sector which even at the state level, I'll request Shri Janaya ji and through him others how to take steps to promote, to encourage this sector, which is the future. Why I am saying future? Because in solar energy we have done well, but unfortunately our manufacturing capability is not up to the mark still. We have got panels mainly from outside, got it installed here and running. In hydrogen sector, there is a potential for our country to be one of the net exporters in about a decade's time and contribute to not only saving of precious foreign exchange, which we have to give for oil imports, which we have to give for say solar and wind energy equipments. We'll be saving that, and on the reverse we'll be earning, if everything goes right after a decade, by exporting the hydrogen fuel produced energy equipments and technology. India today happens to be one of four or five countries which have the basic technology which can go ahead. So that is my advice, that is my request. I know out of the people sitting here, very few will be at present interested, but I have to point out to what the future is also, and where opportunities can be there. Naturally, the pluses and minuses of the time factor, of the delays taken, have to be taken into consideration by the private stakeholders. But I can only draw parallels and say what we felt about solar energy one decade back was similar to what we feel about hydrogen fuel economy today. One decade back, we all know what was the money-wise number game in the solar sector. It was not positive. It was seen as a luxury, waste of money, because cheaper sources of energy was there. So similarly today, the same outlook, initial outlook, if it is there for hydrogen fuel economy, it is not wrong. But then we have to draw lessons from recent history, I'll not say very past history, and see what are the opportunities. And I feel opportunities are great. One has to be patient, one has to be very systematic, and that will lead our country as a leader in this sector in the days to come. I'll not repeat most of the things which we have done here in our state, because that Shri Janaya ji, Shri Prabhakar Rao have already mentioned much more in detail. Because hydrogen fuel also has potential to transform the transport sector in future. There will be a rivalry, there will be a competition between the present EV through batteries and the future hydrogen, the vehicles run by hydrogen fuel. Challenges will be there, but then once it picks up, there won't be any looking back. So this is my message, this is my initial thought to start this session, and I think after the addresses, we'll be open for any questions, clarifications or elaborations of whatever I have said. And I'd like to thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity today to share my thoughts with all of you. Thank you.